Hey guys, Mark here from Revivasoft. Today I'm going to teach you how to fix a slow computer. Now this is a problem that a lot of people seem to have with their computer. I guess it's a problem that's always relative, right? You've got it always seems slow compared to the day you first had it, or sometimes you might go and try somebody else's computer and it's newer, so yours all of a sudden seems slow. So the term slow is all relative. But I want to show you a couple of ways. There's really two main ways to speed up a slow computer, and those two main ways really depend on the type of slowness that you're experiencing. And the two ways that I'm talking about is your computer slow to start up and get going and be usable, and is your computer slow ongoing? So as you're using your computer, you know, a few hours after you've started it up, if it's still slow, then if there's another way to fix that type of problem. So first of all, I'll start with if your computer is slow to start. Now if your computer is slow to start, it typically means that you have too many applications running at startup. So Windows, when it boots up, it loads up all the Windows features and functions, and then it starts loading every application that you have set to run at Windows startup. And if you have a lot of applications, the process of starting each and every application and waiting for it to be finished starting up can take a really long time. Now, to give you some kind of an idea of what applications you have running at startup as a quick glimpse, this is Windows 8, but this is very similar to other versions of Windows. If you go down to the bottom right-hand taskbar, you can see these icons for applications down here. If you have a lot of icons down here, that typically means you have a lot of applications running in the background, and quite often means you've got a lot of those applications also running at startup. So if you have a lot of applications down there and don't recognize many of them, you should really go through a review process and check which ones you should have running at startup, which ones you should not. And in order to do that, you hold the Control, Alt, and Delete buttons together. And this brings up a dialog box, and then you click on the option for Task Manager. Now this is different in Windows 8 than it is from Windows Vista and Windows 7, but the option for Task Manager is the same. So when you click on Task Manager, you then have this option come up. This is a list of processes that are currently running on your computer. This is not the screen we're trying to get to. The screen we're trying to get to is the Startup tab. Now this Startup tab shows all of the applications that are running on your computer at startup. And here you'll see for me, I have quite a few applications listed here, and I don't need all of them. So the really important thing, I can't tell you which applications you have because I haven't seen your computer, but the important thing is to go through each of these individual applications and say to yourself, do I really need that to start when my Windows startup happens? You could wait for it to start later, you could just choose to open it later after startup, but I'll give you an example here. I have iTunes Helper that starts at Windows startup. Now I don't use iTunes immediately when I start my computer. And iTunes Helper is a service that Apple has that checks for updates and helps iTunes start faster. Now, I don't use iTunes on a daily basis, so I don't really need to have iTunes Helper launching every time I start my computer up. So to get rid of this application from running at startup, you right-click on it and then just click Disable. Your option might be different in Windows Vista and Windows 7, but the process is still the same. And then you can go through and do that to all these different applications that you have listed here. Now don't be afraid to disable some ones that you think you might need later. You can always come back to this dialog box and then re-enable them if you've noticed some kind of peculiarity going on. Now some other ones that might be useful to disable are update notifications. There's quite often you'll see ones for Google Update, you'll see ones for instant messaging clients if you have like a Windows Live Messenger or Yahoo Messenger or AOL Messenger. You might also see ones for I wouldn't disable antivirus applications because they're typically needed to run all the time so your system is secure, but sometimes you'll see ones for other media applications, for printers, for things that you just don't really need to run at startup. So go through, be ruthless, go and disable a bunch of startup items, and then restart your computer and notice the impact. You'll notice that it's a lot faster to boot up. So go through that process. Now the second way that your computer might be slow, which I spoke about, was when it is slow in general and it's always kind of slow and sluggish, and that typically means that you have a limited amount of resources that are being consumed, and you can tell that it's getting slow because when you try to open something it takes a long time, like a file or a web page or something, and The way that you have to try and fix that problem is by reducing the amount of resources that you're using all the time on your computer. And you do that by either disabling or uninstalling applications running in the background that you don't need. So the process I just showed you before about turning things off from running at startup actually fixes a lot of this problem, because a lot of these applications that would normally start up and just sit there running in the background all the time will be disabled from even starting at startup. So step one, do what I just mentioned in step one. Step two is actually uninstalling applications you don't need, because that's one, going to free up hard drive space, and two, that is also going to disable whatever process that's associated to the application that you're uninstalling. It's going to stop it from running at all. So to uninstall an application in Windows 8, you need to go to the control panel like every other version of Windows, but to get there it's a little bit different. So you go to the settings option in the charms bar, and then you go to programs and features. So click there, and here you'll find a list of all the different programs that you have installed on your computer. So go through this list and look for ones that you just don't use anymore. Like, if there's ones that you might use, keep them. Don't delete ones that you might use on a frequent basis or even an infrequent basis. But there's a couple of tricks you can do here. One, you can look for applications that have been installed at an older date. There's this column here that's installed on. If you click it, it sorts it by either oldest to newest or newest to oldest, and I've just sorted it from oldest to newest, and you can see that there's quite a few applications here that I had bundled with my computer that I never used. So I don't really use the Dell Support Center, and I very rarely use CyberLink Media Suite, and they're two applications that I could uninstall because I just don't use them, and they probably take up some sort of process or processor usage while I'm using my computer, so it'll have a good impact on PC performance. The other column that's useful is the size column. You can sort by size and find applications that are the biggest and uninstall those. That's one, just going to free up hard drive space, and two, yeah, it's going to help you with whatever processes that are associated with that application. So they're two of the main ways to improve the performance of a PC. I will include a link below to a list of 9 ways to improve the performance of your PC if you want to get even further into the process and make it perform even better. But these two ways will really help you, and I hope that I've been a help today, and I look forward to seeing you in a future Revivasoft video. Thanks, guys.